What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm gonna show you 10 tips for creating an animation in Lumion. Let's get started. First, let's talk about the basics of creating an animation in Lumion. We can start by going to the movie mode. Here we want to record a new clip, so just click on one of these slots and choose record. This is where you can set up the camera path. Now, I will use the settings to make adjustment to the camera. I will first change the focal length so that the camera angle is not too wide by dragging the slider to the right. Or I can double-click and manually enter a value like 35, then press enter. As you can see, the narrow camera angle makes it look more realistic. Next, you can use these arrows to move the eye level up and down, or you can manually type in a specific height here. You can also reset the eye level to the default height of 1.6 meters using this button here. And finally, this button will let you set the eye level horizontal. This is useful when you want the camera angle to be parallel to the ground. Now, I can move the camera to the position that I want, and click this button here to set the first frame, and move the camera to another position, then click that button again to set the second frame. Just repeat this process to add more frames for the clip. If I want to edit a frame, I can just click on it and move the camera to a new position, then click this button to update it. I can also use a small arrow to insert a new frame between clips. Once I'm happy with what I have, I can click here to preview the clip. I can also adjust the length of the clip using these arrows here. Remember that slower camera speed is often better. If you want to delete a frame, then click this button here. After you're done, you can apply some styles to the clip to make it better. Here I'm going to add my own styles preset. If you want to learn more about using effects and styles, then watch this previous video. There we go, now just repeat this process and create more clips. You can also hold and drag a clip to move it to another position. Clicking this button here will let you preview the whole movie. And finally, you can render out the entire movie by using this button here. Or you can use this button to render individual clips. Number 2, Timelapse Effect. A timelapse is simply a video where time seems to move by really fast. For example, in this case, I will use the sun effect to simulate the passing of time. I will first adjust the sun heading to a position I want and click here to add a keyframe, which is indicated by this small dot here. Then, I will move to a different position in the clip and add another keyframe. Now I can use the slider to change the sun position. There we go. To make this look even better, I can adjust the sky and clouds effect to add some clouds movement. Here, I will increase the cloud speed to animate the clouds. I can also use the slider to change the cloud's direction. There we go, looks pretty good. Number 3, day to night animation. To create this effect, I will go back to the sun effect and use this arrow to jump to the first keyframe. Now I'm going to add a keyframe for the sun height, then I'm going to move to the next keyframe on the sun heading slider, and add another keyframe in the same position for the sun height. Then I can adjust the sun height to be lower. This will create the night effect. I will also add some lights to the model, and I will turn on the night activation mode, which will make the lights turn on automatically during the night. Pretty cool, huh? Number 4, animating rain effect. For this one, I will add a keyframe for the precipitation phase and particle size, then I will set both to 0. And I'll move to the next point on the clip and add another keyframe for both settings. Now I can increase these so that it looks like it just started to rain in the scene. For the snow effect, I usually don't have to animate the keyframes because making an adjustment to the settings is already good enough. Number 5. Use animated objects and effects. To do this, go to the build mode under the objects tab. I can add some animated objects such as this bird here. And there are also animated effects such as fountains, fire, smoke, fog, and leaves. I will add a fire effect for this fire pit. And I'll add some smoke as well. Looks pretty good. Number 6. Moving objects effect. First, I can click here and add the move effect. Then I will click this button to start editing. Here, I can select an object that I want to move, and I can set its starting position. Now click this arrow and move the object to the ending position. There we go, super easy. There are also other effects to move objects, such as mass move and advance move, which I will cover in a different video. Number 7. Use motion blur. When creating an animation with fast camera movements or moving objects, you can use motion blur to make your movies more comfortable to watch. Just add the effect and adjust the intensity to whatever you like. Here is a comparison between the clip with and without motion blur. Number 8. Depth of field effect. To create an effect like this, I need to add the depth of field effect. First, I will use the sliders to make the camera focus on the leaves. These settings include amount, foreground and background, focus distance, and sharp area size. This will be the first keyframe. Now I will move to the next point on the clip and add another keyframe. Then adjust the focus distance to make it focus on the cabin. I can animate the other settings too, but I will only use the focus distance because that's all I need. Remember that you can always go back and refine your effect by adding more keyframes if needed. Number 9. TV screen effect. For this effect, you need to go to the build mode and go to the materials tab. Now just select your material. Then you can click here and load a movie file instead of a still image. Just like a normal material, you can adjust the material to be more glossy and emissive to make it look more like a TV screen. Pretty cool, huh? And the last tip is simple, but very important. Be creative and have fun when creating animations. For instance, adding sound effects and music is a great way to enhance your animation. There are lots of great Lumion animations on YouTube that you can use as inspirations. Just learn from their creativity and have fun when creating your own animation. I also recommend you watch this video where I show how to use styles to improve your renders. And that is all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.